पूजा, तो कैन यू जस्ट शेयर सम थॉट्स एंड रिफ्लेक्शंस ऑन योर इंस्टीट्यूट डेज, हाउ इट हेल्प यू और ग्रूम यू इनटू योर जर्नी
And I was always sure that I wanted to become cinematographer, and I wanted to join a film school. I'm from Pune, and FTII was very close to my house. Narayan Dai is from FTII; he's known. So I used to stay on Kamla Nehru Park, very close to Kamla Nehru Park. So it was walking distance, and for me, it was like FTII was like this dream bubble that I wanted to go in. And as I started realizing, I realized that it is very difficult to get in. So what I did was I found out which are the other institutes, you know, I could apply to. So LV Prasad, SRFTI were one of those. I think only LV Prasad and SRFTI I thought of, because these two institutes were the only ones which were sort of funded and had some subsidy. And it wasn't that expensive to get. For middle class people, it's always important to see, you know, this thing was out of question. So when I came to SRFTI, of course, there were certain things that I knew about film school, which helped to, you know, focus on how I wanted to, you know, approach cinematography. And of course, the first year was all inclusive. We learned everything, and it sort of gave me good understanding of other departments. And I think that is also very important to understand, you know, how to co-work with your team, just not your own team, but also to understand, you know, how the direction team works and how. So a lot of people who are aiding, I think it's a good thing that you're doing it, because a cinematographer has to be involved in scheduling a lot, and it helps in a way to understand what are the logistical problems that the direction team faces with the production, and, you know, as a cinematographer, how you can help to solve all of that. So SRFTI was it helped to actually discover myself as a cinematographer, rather more than a cinematographer, I'll say more like as a person, Narayanda, because it is a bubble, you know, right? It's you're from the morning, you know, at 9 o'clock, 8:30 to 9, you go, you do your classes. Evening, there's a screening. So it's, you're living in that whole cinema world. And for 3 years, you're consuming so much cinema, and you're so many people around you. And it's wonderful to, you know, discover yourself, and you understand what kind of films you like. And when I was in SRFTI, the only thing I missed was we did not end up getting a commercial workshop at films, basically. So I wanted to assist a cinematographer who did a lot of commercials, and that's how I ended up assisting Kiran Devans. He's a wonderful master with light. He's so good with lighting, and it helped me understand a lot of things which I probably had neglected or overlooked in film school. Film school is you learn a lot of things, but also at the same time, practical knowledge is also very important, which I think only happens when you sort of work outside. And we had wonderful teachers. You were there, Narayanda. My first year was quite smooth. Second year was a bit of struggle because you left.
Yeah, I did that.
we recovered. We did a lot of... we were little rebels, and we did a lot of... ye chahiye, wo chahiye, and we got things done. Then after assisting Kiran sir, and I was also assisting Shankar Raman sometimes in between. After assisting Kiran sir, I realized that, you know, handling a big set is also a big thing, you know, to understand that how your grip team works, how your gaffers work, and how it's important for an AC to reach at least an hour before the cinematographer reaches. So if my shift was starting at 9, I was usually there on the set by 7:30. To just understand and make sure that before my cinematographer comes on the set, the things that he needs are ready, or sort of little bit of pre-light is ready. So, but this all was possible because I knew how to do my meter readings, and how to do my, you know, how to, what is the light scheme, or all of these just basics were cleared in film school. So film school was that foundation. And then of course, with Kiran sir, I learned his way of doing things. But one point, you know, I started feeling that I want to do something of my own. I mean, as a AC, you're doing what the cinematographer wants, and you're doing it in a good way. You, like, I remember when I met Kiran sir, the first thing he said was, "Pooja, if I like your work, you're in the team. But if you like my work, you choose to be in my team." So it's two-way extreme, you know. I mean, it's a big thing for a person like him to say that if you like my work. And he said, which means not the work, final product is fine, but the process of that, you know, is also important. So it is a two-way thing with when you're an AC and a cinematographer, which I understood, and it's completely different from being a cinematographer. That helped. That cleared a lot of things in my head. And there reached a point where I felt, you know, now I want to shoot something of my own. And Sange, Crossing Bridges, was sort of my first independent feature. I was doing small documentaries, and like I had done Sikkim travelogue, and I had done some ads in Calcutta. But I wanted to do some long format thing, and Sange had sort of some fund which he had from his earlier business, and he wanted to sort of make a short film out of it. So I said, why short film? You have a feature film script which you want to shoot in your village. We'll figure how to do it. And we gathered all our film school, Dhiman and Shonglap and all these people who edited and did sound, and Ayon did the post-production, and Atunu helped us do the promotional things. And it was all film school people coming together, and we were a crew of 10-12 people. Then we thought film will be too difficult to shoot in, because when how will I send the stock from Arunachal to LV Prasad or Ad Labs, and all that was happening, and 5D had just come in. So we did a lot of tests, and then we printed it on a positive, and we projected it and saw how, what is the kind of result we will get. And so Crossing Bridges happened. We shot for 30 days, but in all of that, Naranda, I understood a cinematographer basically has a lot of responsibility, just not as doing the cinematography as a cinematographer, but you are speaking to your production designer, you're speaking to the costume person, you're speaking to the makeup artist. And in Crossing Bridges, I ended up doing costumes, like the costume continuity. I helped Sange schedule the whole 30 days. And because the logistics were a problem, because we were taking lights from Assam, and it was difficult for us to, you know, have lights for so many days. And I knew what are the kind of, how many days I would need something. So basically for 10 days and all that. So all that calculation, and I ended up becoming a sort of executive producer, because after the film got over, we were like, what to do with it now? We have to do something, like we can't just have it on YouTube. So we started looking for, you know, what we can do. So we went to NFDC Film Lab, NFDC Work in Progress Lab actually, and then it went to festivals. Then I looked for I went with Sange, and we spoke to some people, and we got the film sold to different people, and then of course it won a national award, Sange basically for best film. And then now it's on Amazon Prime, it was on Tata Sky, there was some in-flight sales. All of that helped me to basically understand my love for production. So I also do a lot of little bit of production with cinematography. And so a lot of these films that I shoot have sort of been me being a creative producer. Like Atunu's film Rook, which was on Netflix till now, it just went off because it was 3-year contract. Rukh, I almost was sort of a creative producer. I pitched the film to the producer. I had made a docket and sort of a treatment scene and all that. And yeah, Narenda, I've always felt that opportunities need to be created. And in that process, of course, your work gets noticed and people then see your... So in fact, Crossing Bridges was the film that Pratyusha, who directed Safar, she saw. And she saw the trailer and then she said, can I see the film, Pooja? I'm from London Film School. I said, okay. And I sent her the film link. And then she was here and she said, I want to shoot the film. Will you shoot the film for me? And I'm a student, but I said, okay, if it's an interesting project, why not? And that's how Safar also happened. I thought it's quite interesting. Her script was very nice. And I don't know whether people believe in all this. If you wish for something, it happens to you. I was walking through the Bandra lanes. If you all have ever come to Bombay, there are the Bandra village. It's a very nice place, and during Christmas they usually decorate it quite a lot. So I was walking through the lane and I saw this house and I said, "Arey, aise ghar mein shoot karna hai." And you won't believe, that house is the house I shot Safar in.
So, great, okay.